Hi, so I'm down in the New Forest for the weekend, and I'm going to do a trail marathon on Sunday, so I'm looking forward to this. But I thought I'd do a few walks first. So my first port of call is the Boulderwood Deer Sanctuary. So this is just in the car park of the Boulderwood Deer Sanctuary, and there's a couple of wild ponies there. They were right by the car as I pulled in and parked. So yeah, I got this book, the New Forest National Park Great Short Walks for All the Family. So I've got a few walks out of this that I'm going to do over the next couple of days. So today, yeah, it's the Boulderwood Deer Sanctuary. Right, so I'm setting off now out of the car park. Apparently it just goes off along the road for a little bit. Absolutely beautiful, this part of the New Forest. So just driving down to here through the New Forest, it's amazing. Wild ponies everywhere, and just beautiful woodland and heathland. Some more New Forest ponies. It's just beautiful walking down the road here in the New Forest. So I'm on the gravel track now. I've got me a new pair of binoculars just for my hiking. I like to take a pair of binoculars when I go hiking. So I've got some Bushnell Power Views. 10x25, says 300 foot at 1,000 yards, so they seem pretty good. I mean, I haven't really given them a good test out yet, but yeah, they do seem pretty good. You can see quite some way away with them into the distance, you know, probably maybe about 5 miles or something just from my first testing I've done with them. So they seem good. So I've been hunting around, looking everywhere for some deer. I've spotted some deer, but I think they seem to be, I don't know if this is someone's land, so they're actually keeping the deer on their land, but it's meant to be a deer sanctuary, I don't know, some type, I don't know. But maybe the deer are just in this bit here. So, basically still on the gravel track, going around this Boulderwood Deer Sanctuary. And yeah, it's quite nice, just like wooded with all the ferns. And people walking and cycling around. There's like a cycle, mountain bike cycle route. So yeah, but it's not raining, which has made me very happy. So I've been testing out the binoculars, see what I can spot with them. I haven't spotted anything much of interest. I saw the deer with my eyes, not with the binoculars. Anyway, let's get on, do this walk, and then I'll stop and have some lunch, fuel up. Gotta keep fueling up for my marathon on Sunday. I'm now gonna go and see if the ice cream van is still there, and I might have an ice cream before I do something else. That'll be a good move, I think. Anyway, see you later. Right, so I've come to the campsite I'm staying in for the weekend. It's not far from Lyndhurst. It's just out of Lyndhurst, and it's called Foxlease. So there's the toilets and that there, and where you charge your phone up. I've got to put my tent up in a minute, so just in this field, staying in this field, so which I'm really, surprisingly enough, I'm really happy about, because lately I've been going to campsites and there's too many people around, and if you do want to get to sleep a bit early because you want to be up early, they keep you up, so people keeping you up and a lot of noise, so which I'm not overly over the moon about. So hopefully this will be just a ticket and I'll get a bit of peace on this campsite. So all right, let's get the tent up. The tent is fully put up now and it's all looking good, I suppose. It's I've never been to this campsite before, so I had to mind all the molehills and basically just find somewhere that looked fairly decent to chuck my tent on, but there is toilets over there and they've got showers as well, so that's pretty good, and hopefully it won't get too busy here, although someone has turned up next to me there. There's a few people turning up now, so I suppose this campsite is called Foxlease near Lyndhurst, and it's something to do with the girl guiding. They've got an activity center here as well, so let's just show you in the bedroom. Got me old camp bed set up there. That camp bed, I got that off of eBay for about 20 quid. The same ones that they use on the SAS, Who Dares Wins SAS program, I think, as far as I can see. But yeah, they're not too bad. They're not ultra comfortable, but they're stable, and so it's good because it's stable, but it's not quite as comfortable as a blow up bed, obviously. So I am now just going to have a little nibble and something to drink, and then I might go and walk around. They've got some trails going around the campsite, so I might go and have a walk around there. So I will see you in a bit. So I'm just exploring the trails that go out of the campsite. So it says there's a little map you get when you check in, and it says there's trails here that go out into the forest. So I'm just having a walk around, see where it takes me. So after a bit of faffing about and walking around a bit, I realized that I tried to get through one of these gates, another gate just further down there, walking around the site. And then I realized you've got to put the code in to get through the gate. So, basically there's a lot of stuff going on there where I'm staying. It's like a sort of scouting, girl guiding activity center, but they just let general people camp there as well. So I'm now walking around the New Forest, on the New Forest trail, so we'll see where we get, see how far we get around here. Where we go. Anyway, see you in a minute. So I've now found a path to walk on, and I've realized that I can look at my watch and follow the trails on my watch. So I'm gonna see if I can walk down here and then do like a loop and loop back to the campsite again. But it's very, very nice woodland. So let's see where I end up. So I've come to this nice like bit of heathland now, where there's wild ponies and that. They just got scared off by the dogs and the dog walkers there. So I'm now gonna see if I can find the path going up this way, and then I'll do like a big loop. So I saw these people walking from up here, so I thought I'd go and check out where. Ah, I can see. Seems to be a bit of a path there. Yes. Right, I missed that. Hopefully this will be going the right way now. It's not actually on the map on my watch. The other path was, but this path wasn't. So hopefully we're going the right way now, and I'll be able to loop back to the campsite. But it's a glorious day for a walk anyway. The sun's shining now. See you in a bit. So I'm back in the Foxlease grounds now. I found another path on my watch and followed it back, and it led back to Foxlease. And I've come out on a path that I've already been down once already when I was walking around just before I went out into the forest. So, but I know where I am, so I'm not lost. So I might walk the other way through the grounds and just have a walk around. Be a bit nosy. Why not? I want to see everything what's here. See what's going on. So it's very nice place to come, I would think. Anyway, see you in a bit. So I've looped back to the main Foxlease building now. So it's just basically a big complex for girl guiding with an activity center and all that. So as it says, Girl Guiding UK, welcome to Foxlease shop. So I think I'm gonna go and see what they've got in the shop, see what they sell. So that is the Foxlease like estate building, I think, the reception. So yeah, it's quite a good place, this Foxlease. So back in the campsite, in the camping ground, done about 4k in an hour, which is not bad considering I was stopping all the time and didn't exactly know where I was going really. So yeah, so now I'm gonna get cooking and cook a bit of spag bol. Carb myself up for this race on Sunday. So 2 days of carb loading. So let's get the old tent going and let's get cooking. As you can see there, I've improved my little cooking setup a bit. I had a bit of problem with my things keep blowing over all the time, and although I don't like to keep buying too much gear all the time, I did decide to buy some of these for when I'm using my big tent. You know, when I'm just using a backpacking tent, I just use a normal little camping stove. But some of these things I got off of eBay, quite cheap. Although you can get them in Go Outdoors, these things with loads of gas with it, quite cheap as well. 20 quid for one of them and about 4 cans of gas. So I've got 2 of them. Anyway, let's get cooking. Cook myself a spag bol. Cooking up there a treat now. So just waiting for me water to boil up, and then I'll get me a pasta boiling, and jobs are good 'em.